No, that's enough. Go ahead, please.
Thank you, sir. Two questions. One, I know you went through the results and you obviously studied them late last night. What lesson did you learn most from looking at those results? Was there one thing that, as you kind of reviewed them, that you'll change your strategy, not just for Congress, but kind of going forward? And then just a follow-up question.
Well, I think the results that I've learned and maybe confirm, I think people like me. I think people like the job I'm doing, frankly. Because if you look at every place I went to do a rally, I couldn't do it with everybody. And it was very hard to do it with people in Congress because there's just too many, it would be too many stops. But I did it with the Senate. I did it with Andy Barr, as you know. And he won. He won a very tough race against McGrath. I was a very, very tough race in Kentucky. And he was down quite a bit. And I went there, and we had a tremendous, very successful. Some of you were at that rally. And he won that race. But I could only do that so much because there are just so many players involved. But I did focus on the Senate. And we had tremendous success with the Senate. Really tremendous.
Can I ask you one more question? Sorry, Mr. President, one more question, if you don't mind. I'm so sorry, sir. It's a rare opportunity. A lot of people are going to be rushing to Iowa, rushing to New Hampshire. You know that the Democrats are already looking ahead to 2020. Do you want to lock down your ticket right now, sir? Will the vice president be your running mate in 2020?
Well, I haven't asked him, but I hope so. Where are you? Mike, will you be my running mate? Stand up, Mike, please. Raise your right hand. No, I'm only kidding. Will you? Thank you. Okay, good. The answer is yes. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
That was unexpected, but I feel very fine.